everybody, and welcome to Chippokes Plantation State Park. I'm Ranger Kevin, and we're here along the beautiful shores of the James River. Today, we're going to be searching the sediment for breadcrumbs that will lead us to clues about the past. So today, what we're going to be taking a look at are the fossils of Chippokes. Now, in order to really look at a fossil, we have to figure out what makes a fossil a fossil. Starts with the fact that nature is really good at recycling. So all organisms, when they start out, have bacteria. And when those animals pass away, the bacteria automatically starts to work on breaking down those soft tissues. And then other animals like carrion beetles, fox, vulture, they'll come through and try to eat what's left, leaving behind only bones. Okay, so once an animal passes away and leaves just bone, there's two different occurrences that can happen in nature. The most common is what happens every day. So the bone is then deposited and left behind, and then other organisms and time and weather are going to break that down into microscopic pieces that mix in with the soil. In fact, with this deer antler that I found, if you take a closer look, you could see tiny little tooth marks from different squirrels, maybe mice, rats, rabbits. And what they're doing is they're chewing on the bone to get the calcium. So after time, again, this will be gone, which is one of the differences between bone and fossil. In a moment, we're going to step inside of the river house to take a look at our fossil collection, and we'll talk about what makes a fossil so much different. So welcome to the river house in our fossil collection. And what we're going to be discussing at this point is what happens to make that bone into a fossil. And the only way to really do it is as soon as the animal passes away, the animal needs to be completely covered in some sort of sediment. And when I say sediment, I'm talking about things like sand, clay, or other particles that will drop down to the bottom of, say, a lake, stream, or ocean. So once this bone is covered in some sort of sediment, through time, water is going to kind of seep through all of the little pores and cracks. If you take a quick look, you can see, perhaps, that this is full of tiny little holes, even still. And through time, those little holes are going to be filled up with some sort of mineral. In this area, the most common mineral to be included with the bone is going to be calcium. After a while, and more pressure from more sediment being dropped on top of this bone, it's going to harden and eventually become stone. So what makes it even more different is time. So if we were to take these two separate bones outside and leave them there for a certain amount of time, eventually what would happen is that this would deteriorate and be gone forever. But this will still be there. And that is because now, like I said, instead of bone, this is stone. Okay, so what you're taking a look at is our fossil collection table. These are different things that we have found along the shores here at Chippokes. Now we're going to make ourselves into paleontologists, which are scientists that study the history of animals through fossils, and we're going to discover what they can tell us. By looking at the fossils we have collected over the years, we can come up with an understanding of what this area might have looked like. So by looking at things like this big scallop shell, known as Chesapecten jeffersonius, which just so happens to be Virginia's state fossil, we can see that what used to be around here was some sort of ocean. And what makes the ocean so unique
is that it was somewhat shallow and tropical. We can tell it's tropical based on the coral that we find. And then also there is a type of tree oyster that only grew on mangrove trees. So coral and mangrove only grow in tropical areas. So this was a shallow tropical ocean, which the shoreline was all the way over at the fall line in Richmond. So could you imagine going to Virginia Beach, but it's actually the city of Richmond? That would be pretty wild. So this shallow ocean was perfect home for things like fish and whales that would use it as a breeding ground. So it's about 200 feet of water above us. So then we end up with whales like the Io balaenoptera, which was first found in Carmel Church, Virginia, which is a very small whale compared to the large baleen whales you find today. And they would come here to breed and end up being the favorite snack of the megalodon. So this tooth here is not an actual megalodon tooth, but just a replica. And we have that because the one real megalodon tooth we have for display broke in half. So this just gives you an idea of how big it actually was. Now, yes, you can find these here at Chippokes, but they're really hard to find.
All right, so in the past few minutes, we've been discovering what it takes to become a fossil and how those fossils can serve to be the breadcrumbs that lead us to clues about the past. So in order for a fossil to become a fossil, it all starts with an animal or even a plant like a tree passing away or falling down. And then the natural processes of the bacteria and the different enzymes inside the body break down the soft tissues, leaving behind just bone. Then, in order for it to become a fossil, which remember is really rare, it needs to be immediately covered in some sort of sediment. For example, sand. Then, after time has passed and more sand gets dropped down, water is going to seep through and fill the pores of the bone or wood with some sort of mineral, like calcium or calcite. Then more and more sediment is going to be dropped on top, more pressure, and eventually those bones, or even a tree, becomes stone. Because fossilization is a rare occurrence, there's a finite amount of fossils that can be found throughout the world. So they're actually pretty rare. So when you come to visit a Virginia State Park, one thing to keep in mind is that this resource is for all Virginians for perpetuity. And in order to protect that for future generations, it's best to just leave the fossils where they lie. Now, if you feel the absolute need to bring home a piece of Chippokes to remember us by, we encourage you to search for shark's teeth. Over the lifespan of a shark, they'll lose thousands of teeth. And while, yes, it's still a finite resource, they're harder to find, and it makes the resource last a little bit longer. Now, when you're searching for fossils at a Virginia State Park, the best spot to look is along the shore and into the water. Digging into cliffs, like the one behind me, can lead to landslides and also destroy the resource. So when you're fossil hunting at a Virginia State Park, think of your fellow Virginians and let's make memories together. Join me next time as we take a look at how fossils actually make up the foundation of this plantation.